Fortunate are the people who do not have civilization-destroying neighbors. The Armenians, however, cannot be ranked among those happy nations because of various Turkic tribes which penetrated into their homeland from regions as remote as Altai over 1,000 years ago. One of the oldest and most famous cities of historical Armenia, Julfa, used to lie on the left bank of the river Arax in Yerenjak district. Movses Khorenatsi, the father of Armenian historiography, was the first to make reference to Julfa as an Armenian township as early as the 5th century. Julfa is recorded in many historical foreign sources documenting it as an Armenian territory. The city used to have a great number of scriptoria. The oldest of the manuscripts date from 1286. Julfa had several stages of development. The last stage traces back to the early 15th century, when some of the inhabitants of the medieval Armenian capital of Ani resettled in Julfa after the fall of their own city. Half of them escaped to Van and Julfa. The others settled wherever they could. As attested by John Newberry in 1581, Julfa had a population of 3,000 houses. In the late 16th century, the splendid city was considered the magnificent capital of Armenia. Luis Pereira de la Serta, Portugal's ambassador to Persia, visited Julfa on the eve of its residents' deportation by Shah Abbas in 1604. He wrote, "Julfa, lying within three jornatas of Tabriz, is a large Armenian city with no Muslim inhabitants." While deporting Julfa Armenians for the purpose of developing trade and crafts in his country, Shah Abbas was assisted by Tahmazvuli, a Georgian prince of Somkhet who had converted to Islam. According to the Shah's order, Julfa Armenians were given only 3 days to leave the city. Those staying thereafter the deadline were threatened with death. The deportees had to cross the river quickly without sufficient number of boats. As a result, a great number of people drowned. However, that was not the only calamity to befall Julfa Armenians. Shah Abbas called for Tahmazghouli Bey and asked, "Have you not burned down the buildings of the city after the deportation of the residents?" Receiving a negative answer, he ordered that the Bey return and do so. In the spring of the following year, the Persians invaded Julfa for the last time to finally get rid of the remaining Armenian refugees who had managed to escape the deportation. 68 years after the forced displacement of Julfa Armenians, in 1673, French knight Jean Chardin visited Julfa and wrote the following about it. "On the bank of the Arax River, the destroyed city of Old Julfa is located. It has been annihilated beyond recognition, but even the ruins are not able to conceal the magnificence it once enjoyed. It used to lie on the steep slope of a mountain. Many castles protected the entrances to the city that were naturally fortified and difficult to access. As attested by the Armenians, it comprised 4,000 houses, all of which now lie in ruins. The city that offers an attractive view resembles a long amphitheater. At present, it is inhabited by only 30 families, all of them Armenian." Shah Abbas the Great reduced Julfa to total ruins. William Owsley, an English diplomat who visited Julfa in 1812, writes, "We saw the remnants of Julfa, now an annihilated city, lying amidst beautiful rocks and mountains. It is situated on a bank of the Arax, with the remains of a castle and a small tower nearby. I studied the main ruins of Julfa carefully. In the vicinity of an ancient church, a fine tombstone, engraved with some reliefs and an Armenian epitaph, was preserved. From a nearby elevation, I took a photograph of what was once a bridge extending over the river Arax below the city. Madame Chantre, a French investigator who visited the ruins of Julfa in 1890, writes, "All the local remarkable buildings have fallen prey to fire and have been demolished. It is difficult at present to form a mental picture of the original city." In 1894, the world-famous encyclopedia of Brockhaus Yeffron wrote that the only remnants of the city, which once claimed 50,000 inhabitants, now comprised ruins of houses and churches, as well as a large cemetery and the foundations of some two or three bridges lying over the river Arax. Julfa used to boast 9 churches and monasteries, which were as follows: St. Ovanes, St. Gevorg, St. Minas, St. Hagop, St. Andriordi, Surp Asvazadzin, Holy Virgin, Surp Amenapergich, Holy Savior, Surp Yerortutyun, Holy Trinity, Orverin Upper Katan, and Pomblos Jam, Pomblos Church. Although Shah Abbas deported Julfa Armenians and devastated the city, he did not touch the local cemetery extending over 3 hills on the bank of the Arax River in the southwest of the city. The ancient cemetery was a unique specimen of Armenian cultural heritage, which occupied a special place in the treasury of world civilization. French researcher Alexandre de Rhodes, who visited the site of the city 43 years after its fall in 1648, saw 10,000 standing, ornate khachkars, cross stones, there. By the early 20th century, their number had dropped to about 6,000 only, including some ram-shaped tombstones. The cemetery also retained 2 churches and a chapel. As William Owsley writes, that large cemetery, comprising rows of a huge number of standing gravestones that resemble densely arrayed soldiers from afar, is living proof of the number of people the city formerly enjoyed. They perpetuate the memory of many generations, constituting the overall result of many centuries of creative work. Robert Kerr Porter, an English artist and archaeologist who visited Julfa in 1819, describes the cemetery in the following manner: 3 hills densely covered with graves lying within a foot of each other, long vertical stones, some of them between 8 and 10 feet high. You can hardly find a single one that is not skillfully engraved with various reliefs representing crosses, saints, angels, birds, animals, etc. It would not be an exaggeration to say that this